Our gospel passage for today, Friday of the second week of Easter, is St. John's account of the feeding of the multitude, the multiplication of the loaves and fishes. It's the first 15 verses of chapter 6 of John's gospel. One thing I like about this account of the gospel is that Jesus' grace and glory is revealed to us in the context of human needs. People are hungry, and Jesus feeds them. Jesus has the gift, the resources to meet the full range of our human needs. We often look at the multiplication of loaves and fishes as a precursor of the Eucharist, and certainly it is. However, we can't lose sight of the fact that Jesus is there to provide for our human needs as well, to give us our daily bread. The multiplication of loaves and fishes is the only miracle found in all four gospel accounts, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. But John's account is different in this regard. In Matthew, Mark, and Luke, after Jesus multiplies the loaves and fishes, he gives them to the apostles, and then the apostles distribute them to the people. In John's account, Jesus distributes the loaves and the fishes himself. That's John's vision of community. It's non-hierarchical. Jesus comes directly to us. He doesn't have to work through intermediaries. We have the intimate relationship of Jesus coming directly to us. We go directly to Jesus. He comes to us. We have that mutual relationship. I love the non-hierarchical notion of community that St. John has. It's often evident in his parable of the vine and the branches. Also, this being a Easter proclamation reminds us it's the resurrected Christ who provides for our deeds, feeds us certainly in the Eucharist, but also is there to provide for all of our human needs.